with my motorcycle and with two friends, we were thrown 30 feet apart. 30 feet came bar gire. Fortunately, I was conscious. All those people gathered there, helped us to get up from the thing. I had severe pain in my spine, abdomen, and very difficult, you know, to get up from the place, from the road. And then they put us into the taxi. They said, take him to Cooper Hospital. Take it. My friend was put in the rear seat. He had some multiple pelvic fractures. And then instead of going to Cooper, I was conscious. I told the driver, take me to my arm. 78 minutes of traffic. So within 15-20 minutes we reached Malad. Suchak Hospital is the place where my father started in 1950, and I was to join them. As soon as I reached the hospital, they checked my blood pressure. It was almost 40. The blood pressure had dropped because there was internal bleeding. The abdomen had swollen up. They decided that something ruptured in the stomach. We need to take him to the OT. My blood was collected for grouping cross matching, and I was taken. Two surgeons were called in, and one anesthetist. They took me on a table. By time I was on the table, blood pressure already dropped. I was conscious, only given oxygen, and then they intubated me, put me on the machine, anesthesia machine, and when they opened, so all blood came out, almost 3.5-4 liters. The spleen had ruptured. Right side my liver of that, left my spleen of that. Spleen is a soft jelly-like organ. It had ruptured. So much bleeding. And you cannot suture a spleen, so they have to remove the spleen. In the meantime, the anesthetist said that he is not able to feel the pulse. The heart sounds were not seen. So they started doing the massage. Everyone, at that time there were almost 9, 10, 11 doctors, everyone seen, looking at my father. My father was very poor. He said, do your job, do your job. So I was revived on the table. They removed my spleen. They gave me 10 bottles of blood. After the 10 bottle of blood, the blood pressure started coming up. The surgery got over. And then I had to almost rest for about 3-4 weeks, the major surgery. And then I joined again to the same place, but I was going by car then. My father didn't allow me. And after finishing my internship, I did my anesthesia, got married, started working in the hospital. I do critical care, doing all the ICU job, putting lines and all, putting ventilator on the patients and all. So from that time onwards, for 9 years, I was absolutely fine. From 78 to 87. 87 May, I got jaundice. So first thing I thought, okay, we usually, when we were young, we were eating outside, you know, all those pav bhaji and all. I said, hepatitis A ho gaya hoga possible. But when they checked, it was not hepatitis A. It was hepatitis B and something else, we don't know. When 6 months the liver enzymes were high, they asked me to go to England. England mein world ke best doctor was Professor Dr. Sheila Sherlock and Dr. Roger William, King's College. When I went there, they did my liver biopsy. When they did a liver biopsy, they called me for a discussion that there's some continuous damage going on and you got early cirrhosis. The first question they asked me, how old are your children? They are some 7 years and 5 years. We better be careful. I won't say anything, but we'll have to observe. So when they did this thing, they say it is not A hepatitis, not a B hepatitis. Later on, after 1 year, the name of hepatitis C came. So I was labeled as hepatitis C. That kept my sample. At that time, one new drug had come, interferon. They put me on trial. From 1990 to 2005, I took 4 courses of interferon. I was working comfortably in the hospital, no problem. But I never went into a cure. It was a temporary report, used to be normal. After stopping the drug, again, those liver enzymes went back. So from 78 to 2006, it was 28 years, my liver became completely cirrhotic because of hepatitis C. So cirrhosis hone ke baad, we realized there were 2 shadows in my liver, and they were 2 cancers, cancer tumors. So there was no other choice other than liver transplant. 2006 was not good in Mumbai. There were no transplants being done here. Chennai and Delhi, there were the two centers. So I went to Delhi. And there were no organs available from cadaver or disease, what we are going to talk. So you have to take from your family half the liver, and that liver would grow. So my wife was finalized as the liver transplant donor from Bombay. When we went there, unfortunately she was rejected. So again there was a little concern what will happen. In the meantime, my Guruji Swami Chidananji, my Guru Bhai was Swami Yati Garbhananda. He got to know I am not well. He worked with me in 6 months, in 1999-2000, for the change of millennium program. We had 100 saints in Bombay, 10,000 people had organized Divine Society International Conference at Azad Maidan. So he came to Delhi, asked Swamiji, can I help him? His blood group turned out to be same, but I was not comfortable taking half the liver from him. Because after all, he's the same. We cannot, But he was very keen. He went and met my doctor, Dr. Subhadip at Apollo. And fortunately, things were falling in place. His half liver was given to me. My surgery, when it started on 19th February, first of all, to reach the liver, there was a lot of adhesions. To reach the liver, it took almost 6-7 hours. The surgery, it takes about 12 to 14 hours. Went on for 22 hours. I was taken in the morning at 6 a.m. Next day morning 4 o'clock I was brought up. And lot of complications. But I was put on ventilator for 2.5 days. And my, in Shivananda Ashram they did Mahabhutuja Mantra from time of my surgery till I was discharged, 24 hours, 40 days. 40 days. This is the type of blessings I got from the ashram. The school where I am attached, where 2,000 children conducted prayers for me. My hospital staff, they walked from Malad to the other Siddhivinayak temple, barefooted, turn by turn, kept my boss, theek ho jaye. You know, all that love and all that blessings, God was kind on me, things were, you know, if he's put your hand on you, cannot go wrong. So as soon as I started recovering from the state, then I decided okay, my life should be used for something better. So I got the call and mission became to spread awareness of organ donation, to get more cadaver donations. This is people who get brain death. Each person can save 8 lives. So why not work on that? Why a live person should give a part of the organ? Nothing happened to him, his liver grew, he's fine, he's absolutely traveling worldwide. But you always feel that if you can, see, so many organs are wasted every day in the city of Mumbai, everywhere in the country. So we need to educate everybody, make things aware. So I go to different places to make. See, this is the change in outlook before transplant and after transplant. It's almost 13 years now. It's a fully active life. I walk every day about 8 to 10 kilometers. I went for 7 consecutive dream runs, 6 kilometer dream run. I started up like, I used to take a group of people, some doctors, some friends. We used to print about 15,000-20,000 pamphlets on organ donation awareness. You know, distribute everywhere. And after that, I started working in the hospital also. All emergencies I still attend. And then every night or alternate night, I get a call to go to the ICU that your job is being done. After I recovered, I started getting calls from different places. Okay, he will counsel for liver transplant free and organ donation. Anybody wanted to know. So I must have counseled 350-400 patients free. 80 or 100 people have got their transplants done. There are 4 doctors from Bombay. Even they got the transplant. They're all fine. The success rate of transplant is more than 90%. So I've been giving talks everywhere, schools, colleges, wherever they call me for chief, as a chief guest or maybe for some other function, I take out 2-3 minutes for talking on organ donation and then I speak about it. So this is the types of India hope for a dream run, it starts in Manhattan. This is the News 24, I've been giving TV interviews. This is the marathon, this thing. After that, yeah. Next year, I decided to go to Leh by road. So I flew to Manali. I took a car from there. I drove down to Leh Ladakh. And when we went to Leh Ladakh, this Thartula Pass is the highest pass in the world, notable pass, 18,380. Next to me is my daughter. Imagine, she's so young, she was breathless, I went down. So I was so fit. I'm trying to tell you that the quality of life. Even as a doctor, I didn't know before my transplant whether I'll be lying in some corner or, you know, the quality of life is not compromised. So we need to make people aware and see that all transplants are done. This is Alaska event. I do all the adventure sports, zip lining from 10,000 to down, everything else. So this is the doctor who operated me. He must have done almost 3,000 liver transplants. Imagine. This man has saved my life. And still today, if I have any problem or I need to take any input or for follow-up, I speak to him. I send all my reports by email. He calls for he advises. This is my wife, Abha. She's been like a pillar of strength to me all the time during my very difficult times. These are my gifts. Four grandchildren. My son and my daughter got married, and now I spend my evenings with them. Every evening I didn't have time for my children, who I was working 18 hours in the hospital. So now I spend with the grandchildren, play with them on the games, and God has been kind. This is Sachin Tendulkar. I met him at Dr. The famous knee surgeon guy at Dadar. You must have heard. Anand Joshi, he's my classmate. There was an inauguration, the wife Anjali, she heard my story, she signed all those brochures that I support organ donation. And this is wherever his message or request is required, he'll be happy to give. After that I met this gentleman, Amitabh Bachchan, a very humble man. He comes to the gate to take you after the work is done. Come and drop your ticket. So humble, absolutely. He signed all the posters of Indian Medical Association, all the big posters of wherever for organ donation. This is contact of India, he endorses organ donation. This is Mithun Chakraborty. When I launched Indian Liver Foundation, we wanted to go for the prevention of hepatitis B. Free vaccines to be given, whoever comes to the center or to the hospital, we give free vaccines. Thousands of people have been benefited. So he was very helpful in starting the Indian Liver Foundation. He is a Swami Yathugarmananda who gave the part of the liver. This is Irfan Khan, you must have heard. Unfortunately, he is not well now. But second daughter was born in my hospital and he was very close to me. So his wife, they conducted those namaz prayers for me when I was not well. And then he has given a beautiful message on YouTube, a 5 minutes organ donation appeal. Wherever you go to YouTube, you can just type Irfan organ donation, you will find it. These are all the awards I got from different associations. These are my staff. Like my family, I spend every 19th February, I spend time with them. From morning, we have meals together, breakfast together, we pray together. Plus we work together all the time. This is these are all the stage artists. I go for all the flagging off at Wakaton. Then this is the Tamle cricketer, very famous. We went for the Anil Sports for Navi Foundation. This is I'm carrying the torch of faith, running in the wrestling. This is Priya, she comes to IMA. So we had a program with her on organ donation. Ramakrishna Mission, I give lecture here. This is a beautiful auditorium in Vanak. Unfortunately, Hema Malini had come. So I had spoken on awareness of our donation to all the people who attended the function. This is on CNBC, on World Organ Donation Day. These are all the awards. Now we start. See, you need to understand the three D's. One is discover the facts, decide whether to donate, and discuss with your family. Very, very important. First you need to understand, then you make a decision whether you wish to donate, and then you need to inform the family. If you decide to donate and if you, that card remains in the pocket or the wish remains in the heart, your family won't be able to help you. Because you, suddenly something happens, who's going to make the decision? The family. So in good days like birthday or wedding anniversary or something, if you, so you should announce those things nicely, positively. Okay, something happens to me, then I would help you. Everyone is aware, I'm not going to talk the basic thing of organ donation definition, removing tissues or organs from the live or recently dead, and the person who receives is not the recipient. These are the organs, lung, heart, pancreas, liver, kidney, intestine, even there are more organs which I'm going to talk later on. This is a very important act which came in 1994. India was a center for illegal transplants in the 80s. People used to come from USA, Europe, Middle East, Singapore, pay money and get a transplant, buy an organ. They would go to south, small villages. There, it's very unfortunate that from one village there are 200 people, the kidneys are gone. In some other village, 100, for petty amounts of 20,000, 30,000. For the daughter's wedding or, you know, the agriculture didn't work out well that time. So after that, the rule came, and now we are very strict, absolutely strict. No commercial dealing in this thing, it has to be only from the family or from the caregiver. The types of donors, one is the living and one is the deceased. Deceased will talk about the brain death. See, from a living person, what you can take is blood bottles, bone marrow, kidney. You need only half kidney for all your life. God has given you two kidneys. So one kidney you can definitely donate to your family member. He will give a life to somebody. Portion of liver. Liver only grows again. Portion of lung and portion of pancreas. This is from the natural death. Everyone is aware. Eyes, skin, bones and tendons, cartilage, veins and arteries, and middle ear bones. Most important is the brain death. See, how many things are there? If somebody gets a brain death, he will help almost 50 people. 8 new lives and 50 people will be helped. So these are on the list of all the organs. This is a new concept in the Western world, which is done in USA, Sweden, Europe and all, where 35% of the supply is from just a person dies from a heart attack or something. And I have enrolled for organ donation family. Immediately after my death, I am taken to the OT and removed the organ within 15-20 minutes. The infrastructure is so good, they remove all the organs and all those organs can save. So the supply of organs have become much better. This will also come in India. They have applied in Delhi, but still things are not moving as needed. The organ donation rate is very, very low in India. We all need to work on that. We need to make more organs available for people who are dying. The first thing I would like to tell you is every year the organ requirement in our country is about 5.5 to 6 lakhs. 6 lakh organ is about. Usme se 2.5 lakh kidney, 1.5 lakh liver, 50,000 hearts, 1 lakh lungs, some pancreas, and then the almost 10 lakhs of eyes, imagine, for cornea. So out of which kidney transplants hote hai pata hai? Kidneys ke out of what we need is 2.5 lakhs only, for 8 to 10,000, all working. But still, kidney failure patients are on dialysis, so they don't die. But what think about the liver? Out of 1.5 lakh, only 2,000 transplants are done. Out of 1,48,000 are going to die every year. So it's a heart ka hai, lung ka hai. You know, absolutely, we need to seriously work on that. This is a new law which has come, swapping of organs. This is when the blood group in the family doesn't match. Like I am A, my wife is B, and some family has gone the other way. We can swap the organ, same day, simultaneously, along by the law. The most common cause of death, brain death, is cerebral bleeding, cerebral infarction, primary brain tumor, and motor vehicle accidents. Wherever there is anoxia and hypoxia, no oxygen to the brain dies. But then there is a lot of process to confirm the test for brain death, and then they talk to the family. This is the brainstem is the main thing which gets lost, where the control of respiration is there. When the brain dies, you see brainstem dead. And then you have check twice, the gap of 4 to 6 hours, four doctors will check whether your patient is really died or not. There are some tests, EEG from the brain, and you know how to do the test, blood test and all. And uske baad confirm and later on, then they talk to the family. Then somebody does the grief counseling, because the family goes into shock. Somebody says, brain death, okay, he's never going to come back. So then grief counseling is done. After grief counseling, give them some time to settle, and then somebody who knows the topic, if the family wishes to give the organs. And if you ask, who can donate? Can an 85-year-old donate their organs or tissue? Yes. The oldest donor in record in London is 92 years. In Bombay, it is 84 years. In Lilavati, the transplants were done, the lady, because our biologic life, our genetic life is 110 to 120. All of, because of all this pollution and all, people don't live for more than 65, 70, 75. Stress and the quality of life has gone down. But there is a village in Japan where there are more than 150 200 people, more than 100 years of age. So there is no light, there is no vehicles, and you know, just like a isolated living in nature, there are no stresses. So even at that age, 84, 92, those organs will easily last 15, 20 years, no problem. Someone with diabetes, you need to check if the diabetes was not under control, if the organs are not damaged, those organs can be used. Then someone, glasses, no problem. Someone who had cancer, if there is a localized skin cancer, he can be a donor. But if there is an organ donor cancer and there is a spread, he cannot. Someone with HIV cannot. Hepatitis C, there is a new drug which has come. See, billions of people have died because of hepatitis C. These were always through the blood transfusion. Now a beautiful drug has come. Sofosbuvir, that's it. People take for 3 months and they are cured. So, you know, unbelievable success in treating hepatitis C. So their organs can be used. These are the frequently asked questions. If the organ donation occurs from a dead person, is the funeral still possible? Yes. They are absolutely stitched, and you cannot make out their, you know, the family. Nobody would know all the organs have been removed. They're quite nicely done. Are any religion against? If you see, most of the religions are supporting. Most of these spiritual leaders have talked about it. Right from Sadhguru to Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. Everyone is talking about organ donation. One worry is that if I sign a donor card, will the doctor save my life? The doctor's first duty is to save any patient's life. Nobody would think of organs. They are running hospital, and then those organs can be used. Then, if you remember, will the wealthy and influential people get out of town? No. Our chief minister, Vilas Operation, if you remember, he had a liver failure. He had three sons who could easily donate, but everything got late. And then he had to fly to Chile with no oxygen. And unfortunately, we lost him. This is, I met Nasiruddin Shah and Ratna Shah. These are some actors who have made a movie which you will find on YouTube. Its name is Phir Zindagi, Life Continues. The whole story is about the organ donation and it's about 54 minutes if I am not mistaken. And all taking care of the rules and all. They've done a free work. It could never be released in a theater because, you know, it was not a commercial movie. So I would recommend everyone, whoever has computer and internet, can download and easily see or you can see live, you know, Phir Zindagi. I'm going to talk about two small stories. One is about Prabha Raika. This lady was seriously ill with chronic liver disease with cirrhosis in semi-comatose state in Kandivali. I got a call from the doctor that the family wants to meet. It was a Sunday morning and I had a talk in IMA. So I said, come tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning we want to come immediately. Within half an hour, the husband and the brother, they came. They said, your wife is very serious. She needs a liver doctor. Bombay Hospital, Maratha Ramesh. Amrapurkar had seen that patient. Deepak Abraham. So they came and met me. I counseled them. Okay, you need a live donor. You need the amount for the, it's a big amount. It's not a small amount. And the third is the her condition is to improve a little. Then she can be free. See, 11 also Bombay was not good seen. So next year the condition little improved. The family was flown to Delhi. The ambulance had come to the airport, picked up, they went. There were four transplants for 4 days. She was taken in emergency the same night. So imagine the doctor did the transplant, finished by evening. Night she was taken, 24 hours they were on this patient. And after that, fortunately she recovered. Their family called me. Okay, they are very happy and thankful. After a month, a girl walks into my cabin. I thought, okay, some patients are ready from the hospital. She said, doctor, there is a come out of it. I said, what have you done? I want to touch your feet. I said, you are like my daughter. I don't allow you to do it. Tell me, well, you showed us the way my brother has been saved. So I said, how is the donor, the husband, who was doing? Well, his liver was rejected, not taken. So who donated? I donated. I said, you donated. What are you doing? So I am doing final year of management in nursing culture. Very good. Are you married? No. I said, you must be having a big scar. Long scar. Yes, I have a big scar. But I am proud to save my mother's life. She gave me birth. This is part of small organ which will be treasured. I went for her wedding and she's got her daughter now, born. You know, I have kept in touch with these people. So it is like life real stories. You must have heard about this. Nirmala Samantravalkar, 19-year-old daughter, brilliant girl, was to go abroad, passed all her exams. They were staying in Mayor's bungalow. At night, the girl had severe headache, busting headache. And unfortunately, she had a hemorrhage, great hemorrhage. They immediately took her to Lilavati Hospital. In few hours, she was not in a condition to be operated on. Kebhi thoda jaga kar de, space kar de. She had brain death. This lady, in the morning, decided all organs to be donated. Imagine, this is the courage and this is human power, what we talk today now. And I see it from those times. So these are the way how people see their life. This is Arun Jaloda. The wife had a heart transplant earlier. He had to go to America to get a transplant. Now it is done in Bombay. Dr. Anuvay Mule at 40 did 110 heart transplants in Bombay. whether you are affording or not, they arrange money. There are people, the social organizations who work to get the funds, and it's very life-saving. This is the last part of my talk. This is a poem by Robert Test. To remember me, I will live forever. The day will come when my body will lie upon a white sheet, neatly tucked under the four corners of a mattress located in a hospital, busily occupied with the living and dying. Someday, a patient in a serious condition will be taken to the ICU. The person could be lying there and would be very serious, don't know whether he'll make it or not. At a certain moment, that patient did not make it. At a certain moment, a doctor will determine that my brain has ceased to function. It's brain death, ceased, stopped to function. And that for all intent and purposes, my life has stopped. When that happens, don't call this my deathbed. Call this my bed of life. And let my body be used by others to lead fuller lives. Give my blood to the teenager who has been pulled from the wreckage of his car so that he might live to see his grandchildren's day. Give my eyes to a man who has never seen sunrise, a baby's face, or a love in the eyes of a woman. Give my kidneys to one who depend on the machine to exist from week to week. Give my heart to a person whose own heart has caused nothing but endless days of pain. Explore every corner of my brain, take my cells, let them grow so that someday a speechless boy will shout at the crack of a bat and a deaf girl will hear the sound of rain against her window. Take my bones, every muscle, every fiber and every nerve from my body to find a way to make a crippled child walk. Burn what is left of me and scatter the ashes to the wind to help the flower grow. If you must bury something, let it be my faults, my weaknesses, and all my prejudices against my fellow men. Give my sins to the devil and give my soul to the God. If you do what I have asked, I will live forever. Please don't take your organs to heaven. Heaven knows that we need them here on earth. You are not a donor just by signing your donor card. You must also tell your family. This is pledge your organ donation. This is a card, a very small card. You can fill up and keep with you and inform your family. Whenever something happens suddenly, and a couple of times you tell the family, somebody will remember. Otherwise, suddenly all that, nobody would think, you know, so much of shock to the family. Or friends or something who is aware, can tell the family, if somebody wants to donate the whole organ, whole body, that is at Sion, we get the form, it is online also, you can fill up and send. Sir, there are three hospitals, Sion, KM and Jeju. So before I would everyone to ask to keep your eyes closed for a minute. You do pranayams all the time. So take a little deep breath, couple of times. Go inwards. Fill yourself with positivity. Create powerful intention and visualize yourself taking this pledge. Being an organ donor, I will be able to save lives. Being an organ donor, I will be able to save lives. Being an organ donor, I will be able to save lives. Friends, please join me in my crusade of spreading awareness. I would request everyone except Guruji to stand up. Guruji, with the people.